Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trophynet, and welcome back to our Commander playthrough of XCOM 2. We still have this team ready to go, and without further ado, let's launch the mission to recover the advanced power converter. So this is our first real mission, the first mission where we will have full control of all our units. So contrary to what XCOM was in the previous game it was more a kind of a government operation where we tried to repel the aliens attacking Earth. Now we are a real resistance. So the resistance has already weakened the convoy we're gonna try and take over in an attempt to get that power converter. So we should be pretty okay to get there. So there we go, we arrived to launch mission. So we've been dropped off. As I said before, we're gonna start this mission in concealment, so the enemies won't know that we're here.
But it looks like it may have been damaged during the fight. Energy readings are going crazy. I'm guessing we don't have time before it explodes.
Which is, of course, bad. So I'm gonna try and take something which is now actually a time bomb. So we have 8 turns to get there.
Stay in the shadows until we can get a better read on the situation.
So let's try this out. We are at, aside from one, the highest difficulty. So we're gonna have to be careful. So let's see. I would wanna give Jane her first shot, since she's the ranger. Since we don't really have good cover in the neighborhood, I'm gonna just put her in the open. We're still in concealment, so that shouldn't be bad. And then let's just put her right next to this truck. Then we have Terilia. Let's put him a bit closer as well. Let's just put him forward.
Closing on target position now.
And maybe he can go to the left here behind this tree. Can he reach? He could reach that tree, but I'm just gonna put him between the tree and the log over there. Then Geralt. Let's put him straight to the side of this tree here. Although I do like to have someone on the right here as well, which might not be a bad decision. So let's put him right over here on the right. And then let's put Benito, the technician, right next to the tree, right next to Cedric over there. There we go. So that's our first turn of the 8 we have available. Now let's see. We're gonna try and get a bit closer. Let's put Geralt behind this full cover car over here. Maybe he can see something. Maybe, maybe not. No, he doesn't. So let's put Jane Kelly up further as well.
Good copy. Moving on target.
We can't switch characters. Yeah, there's a little trick that you can know if she's gonna spot something or not. Because if you can switch characters, you probably won't be spotting anybody. So let's put Benito right here. You might know Benito from the group therapy sessions we do. The playthroughs of horror games like Outlast. So he's one of those two guys. Let's see. Let's put Cedric right here. And then let's put Geralt a bit closer as well. We don't want to go through fire. I think, yeah, we go through fire if we do that. So let's just put him here right now. We're going to try and move him further to the right.
The advent officers seem more capable than the grunts. We're not sure whether to chalk it up to training or stricter mind control. Commander, we have a chance to do some serious damage here. Before jumping into combat, let's make sure we make the most of our advantage.
So we're going to follow that advice and just put everybody in cover for now, because we don't have any excess turns. Let's see what these guys are doing. Okay, they are getting closer, so that's gonna help us, I think. So we're pretty far off, but I can move diagonally closer to get a better shot. So let's put Geralt behind the truck. Put Jane Kelly up even further. I don't think this should break concealment. There's two soldiers over there as well, so we do need to be careful. And it appears that Geralt... Am I missing something? Are those two guys? No. They aren't. Where are those two other guys? Do we... Oh, yeah, because we missed... Yeah, okay. So, Geralt is behind the truck over there, so let's put... We're gonna put Geralt a bit closer again. Because I don't want to start a fight with those two guys either. Because we wouldn't be able to kill them in one turn. So let's put Geralt here. Probably giving a sight to the other two guys again. And now we can actually see how far we can put Benito to not trigger them. Let's put Cedric closer as well. Put him... I could actually try and put him here. And make him do an overwatch shot if possible together with Jane. So yeah, let's do that. So let's put Cedric on overwatch. I don't think... Can we see those two guys on the left now? Shit. That's a bigger problem. Don't know who though. Apparently someone has eagle eyes. But hey, let's put those two guys in overwatch and that should trigger those two guys. Or not. They are apparently blocked by the truck. Huh. Okay then. So these guys are now both in sight of those other guys. So we do need to be very careful with our next turn. Let's put Cedric here in full cover, but still in sight. And let's put Jane... Ooh, she's gonna get noticed really quickly. Let's put Jane on top of the truck. You know what? Let's put her here. Behind full cover as well. And we're gonna take overwatch shots for all of those. We're pretty close to the power converter, so we can dash for it if needs be. But now let's put overwatch on everybody. And that should hopefully kill those guys. Why is this not triggering? Oh yeah. Fuck, okay, never mind. I'm kind of messing up my mechanics. Overwatch is only triggered by enemies that already know we're there, so... This is gonna be a problem. I'm gonna have to set up a different kind of ambush. So we're pretty much... Okay, so Benito can be put here. So let's do that. I'm gonna try and put everybody... What? No, 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 no. Oh, seriously, come on. That wasn't marked as a spotted style. Okay.
They're disciplined and well-equipped, but their obedience makes them predictable.
Okay, but I think we only triggered those two guys for some reason. Oh, the other guys have gone away. So as long as we don't move too much in the eyes of these guys, that should be fine. The only problem is that I just put Kelly out there in the open. Ooh, this is gonna be annoying. So let's put Geralt right over here. He should have a flanking shot. Yeah, okay, I think I know what I'm gonna do. So let's put Geralt right over here. It shouldn't trigger anything else, I hope. That should give us a flanking shot on this Advent Trooper, which I'm gonna use immediately. And it's not dead, of course. Of course he's not dead. I'm gonna use Benito's grenade and use it on the front of the truck and hopefully kill the officer immediately with that. And that shouldn't trigger any other guys either. And the explosion didn't cause any extra damage because that will be for the next turn. So that should force the officer to move. I might have killed her though. If I go here, do I have sight on that one? That might be an issue. So I am going to just put Cedric here as well. Killing the trooper. Hopefully, 81% shot. Should hit. There we go, 4 damage. Should have let him shoot first. And now I hope the truck blows up, but that's not a certainty. So Cedric got a promotion there. Explode, explode. Okay, it doesn't explode. Okay. So now he pulls back, of course, to the other three guys. The other two guys. Which, of course, are triggered now as well. So why did he move along with him? Okay, so now that's gonna blow up, not damaging anybody, I think.
If we don't stabilize the converter soon, I don't think anybody's going home today.
So we have 3 turns left to turn off this fucking thing. Let's see, I think they're too far apart for a grenade. The guy next to the converter is troublesome, but should be able to be cleared out.
Rangers are uniquely equipped for close quarters combat.
And we could probably use the slash.
They can prove highly effective.
So let's start off with that. So slashes are used to get really, really close to an enemy and deal some damage that, would otherwise not be able to do, because we can do a slash after a dash, so after a second movement. She could die here, she could very well die here, but I'm going to use the slash because it's our best option right now. And hopefully it hits. There we go, critical. So that's 6 damage, which is really, really good. So now we only need one shot to kill that guy, which actually might be Benito's task right now. Because he can get, although he can get the closest, so we're gonna have to check this out, because we're pretty far away from the converter, which might be an issue. So let's put Geralt right over here. No, wait. I'm gonna put Benito closer.
Posizione confermata.
I'm kind of regretting using his grenade for this, but hey. So we have a 78 chance to hit the officer. So he's pretty much dead. I think I'm going to have to bear some hits, but let's put Geralt where Benito was. And hopefully get a shot on the... Ooh. So we can get a shot on the officer. But we won't kill... Well, we don't have a flank shot, is what I'm trying to say. Cedric can do something as well. This is not gonna explode anymore, so I should be safe getting him pretty close to the fire. So let's put him here. He should be getting pretty hot, but I could use a grenade. No, we still don't reach. So let's try and hit the trooper then, because the other ones will probably be bad. So here goes nothing. 46 shot. Yeah, 46% shot missed. Okay. So we have 2 actions and 3 enemies left, which means that we're gonna at least bear one shot. So I have a guaranteed kill for the officer. So I might as well. Oh, he lost his cover. That's amazing. Okay, the shot actually broke the fence that he was hiding behind. So we have a 72% shot to kill that guy. Hopefully Benito does 4 damage. Please, 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 please. Oh, yeah, 5 in the face. Yes, thanks, thanks. Thanks, cousin. Thank you, cousin. And there you go, well-earned promotion. Now we have Geralt, who is going to use his grenade to just bomb the hell out of that officer, because I don't want to risk Jane getting hurt there. So that should hurt him and not Jane. We still have 2 grenades left after that. So there goes the officer, 4. Loot destroyed. Oh, he was carrying loot, apparently. Well, that's sad, but better a dead officer. So he's probably... Yeah, okay, he's gonna pull back. Giving us... Ooh, he's in a bad spot there. But I think I know what he's trying to do. I think there's more enemies behind over there. So I'm gonna have to try and avoid that. We still have 2 turns to dismantle the converter over here. So let's see, we're gonna try and get everybody a bit closer because we only have 2 turns left. Sadly can't reach any cover with Benito, so let's put him a bit closer. Ah, god damn it, he triggered. They're in the fog of war. I mean, what the hell. But that might actually work in our favor. So he's giving a bit of an explanation about the sectoid that just popped out. I think I can actually deal with this, kind of. So let's see, we can put Geralt over here, which should get us a better shot at whatever is over there. We actually have a flank shot at the sectoid, which is interesting in its own right. We could come closer with Cedric as well and see what's gonna happen. Because I think Cedric also has, yeah, he also has this flank shot then. Let's see. We could get close and get ourselves in full cover, probably giving us a better look at... Ooh. Okay. Are these guys close enough for a grenade? No. Okay, so I can grenade that one soldier over there and maybe actually get someone else, but I don't see where everybody else is. So there's what? There should be one more trooper. So let's give Benito a shot at the officer and try to take him out in one go. Oh, yes, thank you. Oh, that was awesome. 5 damage. Okay, he's down. So that leaves us with 1 sectoid and 2 troopers. We have Jane pretty close to where she needs to be. What are my hit chances, actually? Wow. Okay, we actually have a shot at this. So let's get these guys a shot in first. 65, that's a miss. Of course.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
So let's try with Geralt as well. 65 as well. Here we go. Shoot. Okay, 5 damage. Oh, could we kill the sectoid right here? I'm torn between the 70% shot on the trooper or the... Because troopers are dangerous as well. I think I'm gonna go for the trooper. I think that was a kill. 7 damage. Critical hit. Okay, so 1 trooper and 1 sectoid left. And we still have 1 turn to turn that thing off. Okay. So what's the sectoid? He's coming closer. He's ballsy. Oh, he's gonna resurrect. Yeah, okay. So sectoids can resurrect dead soldiers, but that's good, because he wasted his turn. He's not shooting, he's not making anybody panic. And the zombie doesn't have a turn right now. So where's the last trooper? There he is. Okay, we're in full cover. But the game doesn't care. Okay. Okay. We can still handle this.
Commander, the converter is near collapse. It's about to blow.
Okay, so... We have Benito on the sides here, so we could get him a bit closer to take out that trooper. There are no overwatch shots from the enemy. The next thing we need to do is get Jane up here, because she needs to hack this thing, because I don't think anybody else can reach it. Yeah, okay, so it needs to be her. So let's put her here and hack this thing, get it over with. So that's Dom. There we go. It's sad that I can't take the shots, but hey. I think Cedric still has a grenade, so we should be able to take out the sectoid. Wow, that was actually pretty close. There we go, disarm the detonator. Objective complete. Okay.
Readings are returning to normal. Well, mostly normal.
Mostly normal.
Firebrand is en route, but I wouldn't take any chances. Eliminate all remaining hostiles in the area before.
So let's put Geralt. I'm not gonna have a shot, am I? Because he actually put himself in a rather cramped position for my soldiers to hit him. So let's put him over here in full cover. How many? 30%. Because I think Cedric got his promotion already and Geralt didn't. So let's try the 30% shot. If it hits, hooray. If it doesn't, no biggie. So it misses. And now we still have Benito and Cedric, so let's try this. So I think, can I even reach him with a grenade from here? Just out of reach. The AI knows that perfectly, how far I can throw grenades. So let's put him. I will want to put him here, although no, that's in range of the other guys. So let's put him over here. Maybe even over here. I think that should be able to... That should allow him to throw him his grenade over there. So let's put it right here. Shouldn't blow anything else up. Maybe I should even put it closer to this location. Although, if I blow up the truck alongside the sectoid, maybe that would work. Okay, yeah. Okay, so the truck is gonna explode now. Oh. Maybe that's gonna kill Kelly as well. That's would be unfortunate. 29% chance to hit. He's not going to, but I'm gonna try anyway. Ooh, I thought that looked like he shot him in the feet. So I hope the explosion doesn't reach her, because she's gonna be dead. She's gonna be dead. Is she gonna be dead? So the trooper misses his shot, but I think we might have lost Jane here. That might have been my mistake.
Fire's getting close here.
Is it? It's gonna explode. Is she dead? Yeah, she died. She died. God damn it. And I panicked pretty much everybody. God damn it, that was stupid. Yeah, we lost Jane. They are putting themselves in a rather good position for this, though. Okay, this is annoying. So they all started to panic because I blew up my own soldier. So that's a great start for this series. And he misses the 38, which is understandable. And we can't use our panicked soldiers, so this might end badly. So the trooper went straight through the fire and apparently doesn't get burn damage for some reason. Okay. He's not dead, which is good. Which should allow us to take him out. Okay, where are we? Oh shit, they're still panicking. Oh no. Oh no. So I can't shoot at him right now. Okay. 56. I'm not gonna kill him, am I? Oh god, that was lucky. That was lucky. Okay. So we lost our ranger, but we did it. We did it. Okay, so I can live with that. Okay. 50% shots hit to 3.5 damage per attack. And, well, the most damage was dealt by Geralt, who also did the most attacks. And Jane, of course, went under fire the most and moved the furthest. So I always seem to lose her on the first mission. Well, usually not because I blow her up, but...
A few of our people
that was
well
sad.
Promotions, Commander. I'm guessing Shen will probably want to have a word with you too.
Okay. But everybody else got a promotion. So, Benito, what is he going to be? Oh, he is a specialist, so that's great. Because his nickname is the technician as well. So those can be really aggressive or just be medics as well. So we have combat hacker. Then, who is Terelia going to be? Which class? Ooh, the sharpshooter.
Just like it sounds. Our sharpshooters engage enemy targets with pinpoint accuracy from extreme range. They're also trained in pistol marksmanship for the occasional close encounter.
There we go, our first sharpshooter, and we get squad sight, allowing us to target enemies within squad mate's sight, provided we have line of sight, of course. There we go, and then Geralt is gravely wounded, but he will be our heavy.
Serving as
our grenadier.
Experts, the grenadiers provide heavy ordnance delivery whenever and wherever we need it.
Kind of fitting with his nickname, the Butcher, so that's going to be very handy, a heavy. Well, a grenadier. Heavies are from XCOM Enemy Unknown. But we do lose him for 8 days because he's gravely wounded and shaken as well.
These items should prove useful in our ongoing efforts.
So we have the power converter, 4 trooper corpses, 2 officers, and a sectoid. So there's the power converter.
Why are you all just standing around?
Hold it in there.
It's perfect. Come on, let's get it inside.
Yeah, help her out a bit, guys.
Commander, the ongoing stress of combat can shake up even the best of our soldiers. As long as we keep them healthy, I'm sure they'll recover given time.
So Geralt has reduced will, so he is more susceptible to, takeovers as the sectoid did before. The sectoids can take soldiers over. So he has reduced will, so he's weaker to that. But if we have a successful combat mission, he will recover and actually will regain a bit of his will. Now we need to go to engineering, because Shen, the woman you've been seeing in the cutscenes, is in need of us.
Okay, reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from their old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had.
So she's talking to Rover.
It'll work.
Hello, Rover.
Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you'd think. Lily Shen, Chief Engineer, at your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet. He's gone. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself.
But sadly, he died.
You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed with what I can do. It was
Thanks,
an
Shen.
Honor to finally meet you, Commander.
So she's the daughter of the engineer from the previous game, Shen.
I should be able to put some of the stuff together in no time at all. I'd suggest we get started with a medkit. It'll probably come in handy sooner rather than later.
So we'll get a medkit first, because I usually do that anyway, even if the tutorial doesn't want us to. Even if the tutorial forces us to do so. So 35 supplies for a medkit. There we go. So thank you, Shen.
Progress on his research. We should meet him in the lab.
And that will do. Hello.
So much of my own research based upon this simple design. If only I had known. Ah, Commander, excellent timing. There's been some progress.
I've managed. You can see he has scars on the back of his head as well.
Chip implanted into your skull. My analysis reveals that its primary function was that of a conduit, passing a vast amount of data directly to your cerebral cortex. With the primary connection severed, much of that data is lost. Several fragments do remain, however. Ghosts, if you will. Observe. Tactical combat simulations. War games. The sheer volume of encounters you were processing was astounding. It is truly remarkable that you survived as long as you did. Though this may seem disconcerting, there is still some good news. This chip bears a striking resemblance to a medical implant I briefly assisted in developing at the gene therapy clinic in New Providence. My understanding was that the implants were intended for high-ranking Advent officers only, captains or above. Retrieving a chip from such an officer would be the only way to know for certain. A greater understanding of these implants would undoubtedly benefit us all, Commander.
New objective added.
So the aliens used our mind, the Commander's mind, to simulate certain combat situations to assess them better and get a better understanding of us. So now we need to complete the Advent Officer Autopsy research to allow us to get a better understanding of the aliens. There we go.
The officers have clearly been modified to allow for their subordinates to receive new orders psionically. The implanted chip is the key.
So we need to get our hands on one of those chips, and I think we already have, because we did defeat some, there we go. We can do the Advent Officer Autopsy, but we're not going to do that just yet. So we can do modular weapons, researching better weapons, better firearms, or we can do hybrid materials, which goes towards the researching better armor. So let's go for weapons first.
I do find that area of research to be among the more intriguing options available. We'll begin work immediately. I'll send word when a complete report is available.
And with that done, I'm going to take a little break.
That converter up and running, Commander. We're ready for you on the bridge.
So we're going to take a little break, and next time we're going to go over our soldiers, the soldiers that we have, because we have actually 6 soldiers available instead of the 4 that you saw before. Well, 3 now left, because I kind of blew up one. Sorry for that. So with that said, thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here. And don't forget to still upload, add your characters in the comment section below if you want to. If you want to join XCOM, So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!